Dear friends, a very warm welcome in the name of our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ to the 2020 KKMC Hymn Festival. This year's Hymn Festival comes to us online via a recorded worship experience. I encourage all of us to fully participate by singing, reading, and praying along as indicated. May God be glorified and His people edified as we focus on the theme of being an authentic community that is connected and caring. And so, as an authentic community, we gather in Christ's name, celebrating God's promise to us, His servants, remembering that we are called to be His disciples.
The call to worship. Great and marvelous are your deeds, Lord God Almighty. Just and true are your ways, King of the ages. Who will not fear you, O Lord, and bring glory to your name? For you alone are holy. All nations will come and worship you. Let us lift up our voices and sing our praises to Him, our God, our King.
All creatures of our God and King, lift up your and with us sing, oh praise Him, alleluia. Thou burning sun with golden beam, Thou silver moon with softer gleam, oh praise Him, oh praise Him, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. Thou rushing wind that art so strong, ye clouds that sail in heaven along, oh praise Him, alleluia. Thou rising morning praise rejoice, ye lights of evening find a voice, oh praise Him, oh praise Him, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. To hear, alleluia, alleluia. Thou fast so masterful and bright, that givest man both warmth and light. Oh, praise Him, oh, praise Him, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
Amen, sound from his people again. Let me forever
call to confessions. The Spirit of the Lord fills the world and knows our every words and deeds. Let us now open ourselves to the Lord and confess our sins in penitence and faith. Together, merciful God, you make us in your image, with a mind to know you, a heart to love you, and a will to serve you. But our knowledge is imperfect, our love inconstant, our obedience incomplete. Day by day, we fear to grow into your likeness. In your tender love, forgive us through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Lead me, Lord. Lead me in thy righteousness. Make thy way plain before my face. For it is thou, Lord, thou, Lord only, that makest me dwell in safety.
Lead me, Lord, lead me in thy righteousness, make thy way plain before my face. For it is thou, Lord, thou, Lord, only, that makest me dwell in safety.
Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proved God's love towards us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen.
And endless as the heavens above.
Praise Him, you angels, wondrous in might. Praise Him, you servants who in His will delight.
His love is like a father's to his children. Name.
flowers that grow in beauty, like tender grass that soon will disappear. But evermore the love of God is changeless, still shown to those who look to Him in fear.
Peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all, and also with you. Let us pass the peace of Christ to one another.
Hallelujah.
Ask God to make us ready to hear the word and to respond as faithful servants.
Scripture reading. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church from Acts chapter 2, verses 42 to 47, and from 1 John chapter 1, verse 7. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship, to the breaking of bread and to prayer. Everyone was filled with awe at the many wonders and signs performed by the apostles. All the believers were together and had everything in common. They sold property and possessions to give to anyone who had need. Every day they continued to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their homes and ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying the favor of all the people. And the Lord added to their numbers daily those who were being saved. 1 John chapter 1, verse 7. But if we walk in the light, and He is the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, His Son, purifies us from all sin. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Sovereign God, we acknowledge the complex rhythm that make life different for each of us. But we are brought together by a community of faith that interweaves with one another. Individuals bound by a common purpose and circles of concern. We give thanks for this spirit of humanity. In all we do and experience, O God, teach us first to love, for love is most precious. Teach us that love is the truest of all seasons. Give us the desire and willingness to share its beauty.
One way we engender community that's connected and caring, we always ask, have you eaten? It's our way of saying, I care for you. Let's bring authentic community out of the church. We would have heard and read by now that all worship services at churches have been suspended.
Lord, you are good. A stronghold in the day of trouble, and you know all who take refuge in you. Our world is in turmoil because of COVID-19, but we choose to look only to you. Grant us faith that cannot be shaken. When all seems chaotic and bleak, give us divine clarity to see your divine movement. We pray for our pastors. Bless each one with the heart of a shepherd, a heart to care for his flock with eagerness, tender love and humility. We pray for the various ministries. May all involved offer joyful service to develop strong bonds of Christian love, to be united as one body of Christ. We pray for our missionaries. Sustain them every day with fresh strength and your encouragement to remain faithful to their calling.
For our church outreach programs, we ask for open doors of opportunities to show your love in tangible ways. We ask your grace and provision for those who have lost their jobs or had to take a pay cut and have difficulties providing for their family, their children, and their elderly parents. We pray especially for our members who have suffered from the isolation because of the safety measure. We remember our homebound members and their caregivers. Grant each of them your comfort, healing, strength, joy and hope in you, always. May KKMC be your instrument to help those in need, both in and outside our church. In this manner, dear Lord, may we share that Jesus is the way, the truth and the life. Merciful God, hear our prayers, for we pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Where He abides, we go.
calls us to be a praying people. Let us join in prayer, offering intercession to God.
Let us pray for the world. Dear God, we know that you work for the good of those who love you. At this time, we ask for your healing and grace for a world troubled with division, sickness, and violence. We pray for reconciliation in our societies, where stark lines are drawn between us, where hate speech dominates, and where issues are so often and so easily blown out of proportion. Our hearts ache for the countless victims of polarization and prejudice, of natural disasters and climate change, and of the health crisis and economic fallout. Will you please bring them your comfort, healing, and sustenance in tangible ways? We pray for leaders and governments around the world. Guide them to make wise and sound decisions that care for their people and not rule based on selfish motives. Make them compassionate and selfless as they lead the people under their care. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Let us lift our voices and pray for the church. Lord Father, we pray for your church around the world to have the spirit of unity in these uncertain times. May we be united in healing for the sick, feeding the hungry, and caring for the weak, the poor, and the vulnerable. May your church be a witness of your love, not only in what we say, but in all that we do. Lord Father, we lift up our church leaders to you. Continue to nurture in them a heart for service, and inspire them to dig deep into your words and root their lives in you alone. Protect their families and their time with their families. We pray for humility, strength, and wisdom as they lead your people. Lord Father, continue to guide your church to worship you in spirit and in truth. May we be the light to the world and show the world that security and victory come in the name of all-powerful King of Kings and Lord of Lords, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you have promised to hear what we ask in the name of your Son. Accept and fulfill our petitions, we pray. Not as we ask in our ignorance, nor as we deserve in our sinfulness, but as you know and love us, in your Son Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. As our Saviour Christ has taught us, with confidence we now sing the Lord's Prayer.
Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. Worship the Lord in holy splendor. Tremble before him, all the earth. Let us now praise God with the doxology. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Now, God's invitation to a life of Christian discipleship. As we prepare ourselves for the week ahead, be reminded of God's peace and receive God's blessings. Know therefore that the Lord your God is God. He is the faithful God, keeping his covenant of love to 1,000 generations of those who love him and keep his commandments. God has told you what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? But to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with your God.
Thank you.
May the love of God enfold us, the wisdom of the Son enlighten us, and the fire of the Spirit kindle us. And may the blessing of the Lord God come down upon us and remain with us always. Amen.
Oh, let the peace of God rule.